Hi everyone, Monica here with M&D Experience. Today is accountability day 14, and I have 14 more days until my lap band surgery. Yesterday, my husband and I went to the nutrition class, the pre-op nutrition class, and the surgeon pre-op visit. It was a long day. I was very, very overwhelmed listening to all the information they were giving us. I wish I would have split the two appointments up. But we got it all over and done with in one day. And they went over all the pre-op diet explanation. 10 days of pre-op, which I had already known that. And then the nutritionist told us in the class there were more than my husband and I. There were like 7 or 8 people in there. But they told us it'd be like 6 weeks of a transition to solid foods. And when I talked to the doctor and the his clinic nurse, they both said that by the end of the second week, I should already be trying to introduce solid foods into my diet. So it would be 1 week fluid, 1 week pureed, and then by the end of the second week, start introducing solids into my diet. So I was happy to hear that. He wants to go ahead and do this new procedure they're doing. He calls it the I-band. And it's basically a gastric plication with the lap band. So they still put the lap band on. They put it a little bit, just a tiny bit lower than where the regular lap band is. Just a tiny bit lower. And then instead of like on a gastric sleeve, right, you've got your stomach here. And then on a gastric sleeve, they just cut that part off. Well, what they're going to do, instead of cutting it off, they're going to fold it in and then staple it, double staple it. And then they're saying that that's the new, he's done about 23 of them. He said I'd be the 24th one that he does. And he says 13 doctors across the country are already doing them. And that's going to be the newest, latest, and greatest thing. So you're supposed to get weight loss comparable to that of a VSG or gastric sleeve. So, and then along with the band, it just helps to assist in continuing with those small meals. So I went ahead and signed a consent for that, and I'm still doing lots of research so that I have all my questions before the surgery, and I'll go ahead and call the office if I do have any questions. I do have friends in the nursing field, and I do lots of research, and so I feel okay with it right now. One of my friends actually told me that another coworker of ours, she thinks she had gotten that procedure done. So I need to give her a call as well and see what she thought about it and how that's been working for her. Let's see what else. So if you all have heard of the gastric plication where it goes with the lap band, if you or anyone you know has done that procedure, can you please send them my way or let them know to personal message me? I really want to know all about it if I can. I've searched on YouTube and can find lots of little things like procedures from the physicians, but I haven't really seen where there's a person in the weight loss community that has that. So, yeah, send them my way, please. They want me to go in the day before my surgery to do some pre-admission testing. I'm not sure what all that will entail. I've got to make an appointment for it. So I plan on doing that. That's on Monday the 19th. And then, when I go home, he says that it's standard protocol that all his patients go home on 10 days of Lovenox, and that is like a blood thinner to keep from, to prevent from any blood clots. So I'm not really looking forward to that because it's injections into my stomach that either I have to give or my caregiver, which would probably be my husband. He'll have to give them to me. I mean, I'm okay with getting the shots, but the doctor said they will leave you bruises on your stomach and you have to do 10 days worth. I don't know if anybody else has had to do that. One of my friends that went to this physician said she had to do that as well. So, I've already got the prescription for it and I've turned that into my pharmacy. I need to go pick it up. I'll probably go pick it up tomorrow. So that I have that ready. What else? I did lose 4 pounds since my last doctor visit. They had me at 249 at the doctor's office the last time I went, and this time I was 244. So actually, I guess it's a 5 pound loss. No, they had me at 248. They had me at 248, and I was at 244 this time. So it's a 4 pound loss. So I was happy about that. They did say that 80% of the patients that are expected to be outpatient only, about 80% of them end up staying, going ahead and staying one night, either because they're, well, mainly because they're not well enough to go home. So they're either severely nauseated or haven't walked around enough or haven't hydrated enough. So I told my husband, as soon as I seem awake and alert, ask me if I need to get up and walk around, because I want to walk and drink, sip as much water as I can, and get up and walk as much as I can. I really don't want to stay the night in the hospital. If I do have to, I will, but it's not something I was really planning on doing. I'm glad my husband went to the nutrition class with me, because he was shocked at how in-depth it's going to be for this procedure, how long the liquid diet is going to be, how long the post-op regimen is going to be. And so yeah, I'm really glad that he, even though I've told him everything, it's good to hear it from a professional, with his own ears, from a professional. So just to reiterate it all one more time. And so it was like he'd never heard it before. So I think he's going to be really supportive. At some point, I do want to do a little session where I try on some of my clothes that fit me too tight now, and I can try them on for y'all. I'll probably do that tomorrow or the next day. We'll see when I can fit that in. But there's a couple of pairs of jeans that I know don't fit me anymore that I would really like to fit into, and I want to try them on to see how tight they fit now versus how much they fit maybe in a few months or so. And then with that plication, with that gastric plication or I-band, he also said I wouldn't require as many adjustments or fills as a person with just a regular lap band would require. He said I would probably only need 2 to 3 the first year, as opposed to 4 to 6 or even more for some people, depending on how often they need them. Because that stomach is so much smaller by folding it in. So, I thought that was a good thing too. The less visits, the better for me. As far as fills and things go, he did say every time we did it, though, we'd probably require a fluoroscopy so that he could check the stomach and see how it's progressing, and there is a chance that those staples could come loose, and so just to see how the stomach is and if there's anything he needs to do. But yeah, that was one of the chances, one of the risks. I think that's it. Yeah, I'm still going through lots of, taste bud changes, and, let's see, today I had a protein shake for breakfast and some almonds, And then for lunch, I had a leftover Zio's lasagna that my daughter had ordered. And then for dinner, I had leftovers from the night before, which is like ground beef with potatoes and green beans and corn. I did have tortillas with it, but I'm not even really craving anything sweet after dinner anymore. So that's a good thing. It really is, because if you know me, I had a major sweet tooth. So I'm really happy about that. I was actually able to wear my rings today, and I think it's because of all my swelling and my body has finally gone down. And just from being bloated and retaining so much water all the time. Do any of you use chewable Centrum vitamins, and are they good? I had bought some Flintstones Complete, and they just taste crappy. And I don't know, what recommendations do you have for chewable multivitamin that's just over the counter that I can get at the store? Also, a chewable calcium, what's your recommendation on that? And then a chewable iron, if you're taking chewable irons, a chewable iron tablet or whatever. Which one do you take, and which one tastes better? Anyway, holler back at me, and y'all let me know. I also want to go ahead and talk about the surgeries. There were a couple this week. What is his name? Slim and Sam was yesterday or this morning, actually, I think. Let's see. Banded Carissa had her lap band yesterday. And then Slim and Sam had his bypass today. Tomorrow is Candy's Sweet Enough, and she is having her bypass. And then on Friday is Cookie's lap band. I'm so excited about hers. I've just been seeing your videos, and you just give me so much hope, because you seem like you have so much hope for a positive future for you and your kids and your family. And I really enjoy watching you, and I wish nothing but success for you. I really do. I know you're gonna do great. Let's see, who else? There were some other ones that, found out today, I'm so happy, that Change for Life 34, she is having her lap band 3 days after mine. So we're gonna be, I told her we'd be lap band twins. We're gonna be sharing our anniversary around the same time. Next week is Sooner Banded, and she's having her bypass, and she's the one that lives here in Oklahoma somewhere. And then Crazy Jenny in Canada, I believe, she's having her bypass next week. So she has been showing her liquid pre-op diet, and oh my gosh, it seems very, very strict, but looks like she's doing it. I don't know how she's doing it, but she is. Cookie's lap band journey, I'm so jealous, because she only gets a day of liquid diet, and then she just has to hold her liquids the night before surgery, and that's it. I want a liquid diet like that. But I'm just worried about, I think once, let's see, I have to travel for work on the, I start my liquid diet Saturday, it's coming Saturday, and then I have to travel for work that Friday. So I'm a little nervous about it, but I think if I pack some canned soup and maybe some Jell-O, I think I'll be okay. With Christmas parties and things like that, I'm just not going to be able to really participate very much, because I don't want to be tempted. I'm hoping that after a day or two, that temptation will wear off. And it won't be difficult for me to be in those situations, because it's all right before Christmas, and there's just lots of things going on right around there. But I have to keep focused, and I know what my goal is, and I can get through it. And if Crazy Jenny can get through hers, which is very strict, I think it's like four shakes a day, then I can get through mine, which I can at least have Jell-O and yogurt and things like that. So, I think that's all for now. I hope to hear from y'all. Please comment. Please like. Please rate my page. And if you know of anyone that I could benefit from, send them my way and I'll be glad to subscribe to them. Thank you to all my new subscribers. Thank you to those that take the time to like or comment on my page. I really appreciate you. Shout out to Jeanette. Happy 21st. Hope you're doing good and enjoying your birthday week. Love you. And I'll talk to y'all later, okay? See ya. Bye.